Hi there, it's Noah Gray from djembe.rhythms.com. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to do a basic roll for 4-4 rhythms. This is sort of the next step after you're a beginning drummer and you're just doing the single notes, whether it's bass, tone, slap. You can do rolls, not normally with the bass, but with the slaps or the tones, you get into more of a solo type of roll. The dancers seem to feed off more of a, you know, dynamic feel that the rolls supply. And I'll just give you an example. The simplest type of roll, you're just doubling the first notes, the first two tones. Now it's the same timing as 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2, 2, 2, 2, 4 tones and a slap. But you're adding, you're doubling the first one, so in effect you're getting 5 tones before the slap. Now because you doubled, you altered the right-left sequence. So instead of right, left, you're doing, you're ending up on the left because you've added an extra note in there. Timing is the same. Now, just to speed that up, and add another slap. And there's, to break it down even more of a fine-tuned way, when you go into that roll, you can think of it in two ways. You can just double the first note. Or you can think of taking the first two notes, instead of you make 3. So you can think of it either as a flam, a doubling, or you can think of it as turning 2 into a 3, a triplet feel. Let's try the first feel, the flam, the doubled note first. Now let's try the more of a triplet feel. Now that's at a slow speed, you can maybe feel the difference. It doesn't really matter. Once you get up to speed, you're not going to hear the difference in that feel very much. It's more like getting into it as a beginner to get your hands to feel how to make that roll natural. So you can think of it either way, you can experiment both ways, and you can try, once you get it so that it feels comfortable leading with your right hand or your left hand, whichever way, then switch and try the other hand. So I'll show you what I mean, starting with the right hand. Starting with the left hand. The more you practice with both hands, the better you'll be in a, you know, dynamic situation where you can switch back and forth. You can do different complicated patterns and come out to the hand you need to by starting with the appropriate hand to end up where you want to be. It just gives you more options to be able to be fluent with both hands. So practice it both ways and have fun.